Hey guys, let's get more news about Lakers, but first, don't forget to subscribe and leave your like. Details emerge about the potential contract LeBron James is seeking. LeBron James and the Los Angeles Lakers will have some big choices to make in a few months. The four-time champion and future Hall of Famer has a $51.4 million player option for next season. It's not entirely clear what James will do with that option, as he could either stick with the Lakers or choose to move to another team. According to NBA insider Brian Windhorst, via Legion Hoops, James is hoping to remain with the Lakers, but his return will cost a pretty penny. Windhorst says that James wants to sign a three-year, nine-figure deal with the iconic franchise. That's an awful lot of money, but the Lakers will likely do whatever they must to make it happen. However, there are questions swirling around James and his future. Of course, he's 39 years old, so it's not even guaranteed that he'd be able to finish a three-year deal with the Lakers. At the same time, he is still putting up phenomenal numbers and proving that age really isn't slowing him down like it has many other people in the NBA's past. If James finishes his next 3 years with the Lakers and keeps setting the gold standard for someone his age, this would be money well spent. The specifics of a deal between both sides need to be worked out, but Windhorst's reporting reveals that James wants to remain with the Lakers, which is very good news for the team. Apart from a new contract with James, the Lakers will have to acquire a better roster around him in the summer. With this new potential deal and additions to the team, LA's front office will have a lot of work to do in the offseason. LeBron James saved the Los Angeles Lakers. Regardless of how fans may have felt about him before he came to LA, LeBron deciding to sign with the Lakers made the franchise relevant again after the worst stretch it has ever seen. The Lakers were on a decade-long stretch of not making the playoffs and whiffed on every move they tried to make. LeBron signing brought notoriety back to the franchise, allowed the team to trade for Anthony Davis, and eventually led to a championship. None of that is possible without LeBron. At 39 years old with a player option after this season, many are wondering if this is the end of the road for LeBron in Los Angeles. With Bronny James potentially coming into the league next season, LeBron could live out his dream of playing with one of his sons in the NBA. But that might not be the case. If ESPN's Brian Windhorst is to be believed, and he is always right about LeBron moves, LeBron might actually be eyeballing a big payday from the Lakers, not a departure. If LeBron James wants a new three-year deal that pays him around $60 million per season, then the Lakers are going to do it. The Lakers paid Kobe Bryant massive money late in his career when they didn't need to, and the team will likely do the same for LeBron. Jeannie Buss is concerned about the team's image and wants other stars to know that the Lakers will take care of their star players. The optics of LeBron leaving the Lakers would be awful for Buss, which is why the team will fork over whatever he is asking for even if another team is not offering it. And this would be a mistake by the Lakers. It is not rocket science to figure out why. A three-year deal would pay LeBron until he is 42 years old. Sure, he is breaking down age barriers right now, but there is a chance of the wheels falling off at any point. One big injury can essentially end LeBron's run as a star player. Just look at what happened to Kobe with his Achilles. The Lakers are not winning a title if they are paying both LeBron and Anthony Davis over $120 million combined. Sure, the salary cap will go up, so there will be more money to spend around them, but that is simply too much. LeBron is only going to get worse with age, not better, and there is always the risk of injury with AD. Then there is the Trae Young wild card of this situation. The Lakers have been heavily tied to Young as an off-season trade destination, which would make this situation even worse. The Lakers would be going all in on three players who are getting older and would not mesh well together. Just like with the Russell Westbrook trade, this would blow up in the team's face. But instead of Westbrook being the former star who is getting paid way too much, it would be LeBron James. Kendrick Perkins issues a warning to the Lakers. The Los Angeles Lakers suffered a disappointing loss to the Phoenix Suns on Sunday and are about to endure a tough stretch of games. Because of this, Kendrick Perkins believes the team is at serious risk of not even making the playoffs this year. The Lakers better be worried about making the playoffs, let alone making a run in the playoffs, Perkins said on Monday's First Take. Perkins noted that the playoffs had started because other teams like the Golden State Warriors, Denver Nuggets, and others are performing with their focus solely on the start of the postseason in a few months. Meanwhile, the Lakers are set to face the Minnesota Timberwolves, Los Angeles Clippers, Oklahoma City Thunder, and more in the weeks ahead. Perkins' warning might be a wake-up call to the Lakers, who are in a situation that's very similar to the one they experienced in 2022-23. At this point last season, the team was struggling and their playoff spot looked uncertain. Of course, fans remember that they surged ahead in the final weeks of the season and eventually pushed all the way to the Western Conference Finals. Does the same fate await them this year? Perkins said that the team is lacking depth, especially when it comes to big men. After Anthony Davis, the Lakers have been forced to rely on an inconsistent Jackson Hayes and an injured Christian Wood. He claims the Lakers will need to make a big change in the upcoming offseason, signing either Donovan Mitchell or Trae Young. But what can be done until then? How does the team survive a daunting upcoming slate of games and secure a spot in the playoffs? In many ways, reaching the postseason this year looks even harder than it did last year. Lakers must sign this veteran free agent after whiffing on Spencer Dinwiddie. The Los Angeles Lakers did nothing at the 2024 trade deadline as there were no deals that became available to the team. Instead, the big fish that the Lakers caught right after the deadline was Spencer Dinwiddie, who was traded to the Toronto Raptors and subsequently released. Dinwiddie, at the very least, was signed to provide the Lakers with D'Angelo Russell insurance. If D'Lo's hot streak ended and he reverted back to his old ways in the playoffs, then the Lakers had another point guard to throw at teams. The hope was that Dinwiddie's play would reverse course from what it had been all season. That has not necessarily been the case as the veteran point guard has struggled in Los Angeles. It is a small sample size, to be fair, but it is hard to be impressed with what Dinwiddie has done thus far. The Lakers do not have the luxury of waiting for Dinwiddie to figure it out, and with so many injuries on the roster, the team can use all the depth it can get. With that in mind, there is one current veteran free agent that could give the Lakers what they need if Dinwiddie ends up being a bust. Veteran sharpshooter Joe Harris was waived by the Detroit Pistons at the trade deadline and has not signed with a new team yet. Normally, someone like Harris would be scooped up instantly by a contending team, but the new rules under the CBA have killed his market. No teams over the second tax apron, which are most of the contenders, could sign Harris after he was waived because his salary was so high. That left the mid-tier contenders, like the Lakers, and no team has stepped forward to sign Harris. The Lakers still have $3.3 million in space before reaching the first tax apron, so the team has the ability to add a minimum free agent without incurring any additional penalties. Harris definitely makes the most sense of anyone on the depleted market if the Lakers want to take advantage of the space the team has. Harris is a career 40% three-point shooter who has led the league in three-point percentage twice in his career. Hit shooting numbers are down this season, but that could be a product of the terrible system in Detroit more so than his ability to hit threes. If the Lakers are going to make a run in the playoffs, then they need someone who can consistently hit threes off the bench. If Rui Hachimura is staying in the starting lineup once Jared Vanderbilt returns, then LA will not have a single consistent shooter to turn to off the bench. The one hiccup that the Lakers have is there are not many candidates to waive this season. The only players that could reasonably be waived are Dinwiddie, Max Christie, and Taurean Prince. Prince is the obvious choice of those three, but Darvin Ham loves him too much for the team to do that. But then again, once Vando is healthy, there is really no need for Prince, so waiving him in favor of a shooter like Harris might be the move. And you, fan, what do you think of the situation about Joe Harris? Leave your opinion in the comments.